This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. U.S. Senator from Vermont tenure 2010 Tax Relief Act filibuster 2006 election 2012 re-election U.S. Representative for Vermont's at-large tenure CPC 1988 campaign Mayor of Burlington tenure 1962 University of Chicago sit-ins We Shall Overcome VE part of a series on progressivism ideas. Idea of progress scientific progress social progress economic development technological change linear history history enlightenment industrial revolution modernity politics portal VE social democracy development humanism age of enlightenment French Revolution Utopian Socialism Revolutions of 1848 Marxism Orthodox Revisionist Ethical Socialism Democratic Socialism Liberal Socialism Market Socialism Progressivism Reformism Gradualism Frankfurt Declaration Keynesianism Welfare Capitalism Third Way Modern European Socialism Ideas Social Justice Democracy Economic Representative Labor Rights Mixed Economy Welfare Trade Unionism Fair Trade Environmental Protection Negative and Positive Rights Secularism Social Corporatism Social Market Economy Variants Bernsteinism Liberal Socialism Nordic Model Godesberg Third Way People Atli Awolowo Ben-Gurion Bernstein Betancourt Budo Blanc Brandt Branting Craxi Crossland Curtin Dushinsky Debs Douglas Esavit Gonzalez Goulart Hilferding Jaurès Junmai Katayama LaSalle Leighton Levesque MacDonald Mandela Nehru Battle Y Ordonez Palm Plekhanov Prodi. Sanders Savage Stoning Thomas Organizations Social Democratic Parties Socialist International International Union of Socialist Youth Party of European Socialists Progressive Alliance Young European Socialists International Trade Union Confederation Socialism Portal Economics Portal Politics Portal V.E. Bernard Bernie Sanders born September 8, 1941 as an American. Politician who has been the junior United States Senator from Vermont since 2007 Sanders is the longest-serving independent in U.S. congressional history since his election to the U.S. House in 1991. He has caucused with the Democratic Party, which has entitled him to committee assignments and at times given Democrats a majority Sanders became the ranking minority member on the Senate Budget Committee in January 2015. He had previously served for 2 years as chair of the Senate Veterans Affairs Committee Sanders' campaign against Hillary Clinton for the party's 2016 U.S. presidential nomination raised more money in small, individual contributions than any other in American history, and helped Sanders rise to international recognition. This was the only time in Sanders' career that he publicly identified as a Democrat, and he has since announced he will return to the Senate as an independent, a self-described Democratic Socialist. Sanders is pro-labor and emphasizes reversing economic inequality. Many scholars consider his views to be more in line with social democracy and New Deal-era American progressivism than democratic socialism. Sanders was born and raised in the Brooklyn borough of New York and graduated from the University of Chicago in 1964. While a student, he was an active civil rights protest organizer for the Congress of Racial Equality and the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee. After settling in Vermont in 1968, Sanders ran unsuccessful third-party campaigns for governor and U.S. senator in the early to mid-1970s as an independent. He was elected mayor of Burlington, Vermont's most populous city, in 1981, where he was re-elected 3 times in 1990 he was elected to represent Vermont's at-large congressional district in the U.S. House of Representatives, where he co-founded the Congressional Progressive Caucus in 1991 he served as a congressman for 16 years before being elected to the U.S. Senate in 2006 In 2012, he was re-elected with 71% of the popular vote polls indicate that he is among the senators most popular with their constituents. Ranking third in 2014 and first in both 2015 and 2016 Sanders rose to national prominence following his 2010 filibuster against the Middle Class Tax Relief Act of 2010, which extended the Bush tax cuts for the wealthiest Americans by favoring policies based largely on the Nordic model of social democracy and Franklin D. Roosevelt's New Deal. Sanders has built a reputation as a leading progressive voice on issues such as campaign finance reform, corporate welfare, global warming, income income inequality, LGBT rights, parental leave, and universal health care. Sanders has long been critical of U.S. foreign policy and was an early and outspoken opponent of the Iraq War, the First Gulf War, and U.S. support for the Contras in Nicaragua. He is also outspoken on civil liberties and civil rights, particularly criticizing racial discrimination in the criminal justice system as well as advocating for privacy rights against mass surveillance policies such as the USA Patriot Act and the NSA surveillance programs. Sanders announced his campaign for the Democratic presidential nomination on April 30, 2015. He became the first Jewish American to win a presidential primary contest when he defeated eventual nominee Hillary Clinton in New Hampshire on February 9, 2016. Initially considered a long shot, Sanders won 23 primaries and caucuses and approximately 43% of pledged delegates to Clinton's 55%. His campaign was noted for the enthusiasm of its supporters, as well as his rejection of large donations from corporations, the financial industry, and any associated super PAC. The campaign instead relied on a record-breaking number of small, individual contributions. On July 12, 2016, Sanders formally endorsed Clinton against her U.S. Republican general election opponent Donald Trump, while urging his supporters to continue the political revolution his campaign had begun. He has started a successor 501c4 organization, Our Revolution, to recruit and support candidates for local, state, and national office. He has also announced the upcoming creation of the Sanders Institute, which will promote his policy agenda through documentary films and other media contents. 1. Early life. 2. Early career. 21. Early political activism. 22. Professional history. 23. Liberty Union campaigns. 24. Mayor of Burlington. 3. U.S. House of Representatives. 31. Elections. 32. Tenure. 4. U.S. Senate. 41. Elections. 42. Tenure. 421. Budget. 422. Senate Budget Committee. 423. Committee assignments. 5. 2016 Presidential Campaign. 51. Democratic Party Presidential Debates. 52. Party affiliation since 2015. 53. Our Revolution Organization. 6. Political positions. 7. Personal life. 71. Religion and heritage. 8. See also. 9. Notes. 10. References. 11. Further reading. 12. External links. Early life. Bernard Sanders was born on September 8, 1941, in Brooklyn, New York City. His father, Elias Sanders, was born on September 14, 1904 in Slopnice, Poland, then the Austro-Hungarian province of Galicia, to a Jewish family. In 1921, Elias immigrated to the United States at age 17. His mother, Dorothy Sanders Ney, P.S. 197 in Brooklyn, where he won a borough championship on the basketball team. He attended Hebrew school in the afternoons, and celebrated his bar mitzvah in 1954. Bernie's older brother, Larry, said that during Bernie's childhood, the family never lacked for food or clothing, but major purchases, like curtains or a rug, were difficult to afford. Sanders attended James Madison High School, also in Brooklyn, where he was captain of the track team and took third place in the New York City indoor one-mile race in high school. Sanders lost his first election, finishing last out of three candidates for the student body presidency not long after his high school graduation. His mother died at the age of 46. His father died a few years later on August 4, 1962. At the age of 57, Sanders studied at Brooklyn College for a year in 1959-60 before transferring to the University of Chicago and graduating with a Bachelor of Arts degree in political science in 1964. He has described himself as a mediocre college student because the classroom was boring and irrelevant, while the community provided his most significant learning. Early career. Main article, Electoral History of Bernie Sanders. Early political activism. Sanders being arrested at a 1963 anti-segregation protest in Chicago. He was later found guilty of resisting arrest and fined $25. While at the University of Chicago, Sanders joined the Young People's Socialist League, the youth affiliate of the Socialist Party of America, and was active in the civil rights movement as a student organizer for the Congress of Racial Equality Corps and the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee under Sanders's chairmanship. The University Chapter of Corps merged with the University Chapter of SNCC in January 1962. Sanders led a rally at the University of Chicago Administration Building to protest University President George Wells' Charles Beadle's segregated campus housing policy, "We feel it is an intolerable situation when Negro and white students of the university cannot live together in university-owned apartments," Sanders said at the protest. Sanders and 32 other students then entered the building and camped outside the president's office, performing the first civil rights sit-in in Chicago history after weeks of sit-ins. Beadle and the university formed a commission to investigate discrimination. Joan Mahoney, a member of the University of Chicago Core chapter at the time and a fellow participant in the sit-ins, described Sanders in a 2016 interview as "a swell guy, a nice Jewish boy from Brooklyn, but he wasn't terribly charismatic. One of his strengths, though, was his ability to work with a wide group of people, even those he didn't agree with." Sanders once spent a day putting up flyers protesting against police brutality, only to eventually notice that a Chicago police car was shadowing him and taking them all down. Sanders attended the 1963 March on Washington for Jobs and Freedom, where Martin Luther King Jr. gave his "I Have a Dream" speech that summer. He was convicted of resisting arrest during a demonstration against segregation in Chicago's public schools and was fined $25. In addition to his civil rights activism during the 1960s and 1970s, Sanders was active in several peace and anti-war movements. He was a member of the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee and the Student Peace Union while attending the University of Chicago. Sanders applied for conscientious objector status during the Vietnam War. His application was eventually turned down, by which point he was too old to be drafted, although he opposed the war. Sanders never criticized those who fought and has been a strong supporter of veterans' benefits. Professional history. After graduating from college, Sanders returned to New York City, where he initially worked at a variety of jobs, including Head Start teacher, psychiatric aide, and carpenter. In 1968, Sanders moved to Vermont because he had been captivated by rural life. After his arrival there, he worked as a carpenter, filmmaker, and writer who created and sold radical film strips and other educational materials to schools. He also wrote several articles for the alternative publication The Vermont Freeman Liberty Union Campaigns. Sanders began his electoral political career in 1971 as a member of the Liberty Union Party, which originated in the anti-war movement and the People's Party. He ran as the Liberty Union candidate for governor of Vermont in 1972 and 1976 and as a candidate for U.S. Senator in 1972 and 1974 in the 1974 senatorial race. Sanders finished third, 5,901 votes, 41%, behind 33-year-old Chittenden County State's Attorney Patrick Leahy D.V., 70,629 votes, 494%, and two-term incumbent U.S. Representative Dick Mallory R., 66,223 votes, 463%. The 1976 campaign proved to be the zenith of Liberty Union's influence, with Sanders collecting 11,000 votes for governor and the party. This forced the races for lieutenant governor and secretary of state to be decided by the state legislature when its vote total prevented either the Republican or Democratic candidates for those offices from garnering a majority of votes. The campaign drained the finances and energy of the Liberty Union, however, and in October 1977, less than a year after the conclusion of the 1976 campaign, Sanders and the Liberty Union candidate for Attorney General, Nancy Kaufman, announced their retirement from the party following his resignation from Liberty Union. Sanders worked as a writer and the director of the nonprofit American People's Historical Society APHS. While with the APHS, he made a 30-minute documentary about American socialist leader and presidential candidate Eugene V. Debs. Mayor of Burlington. Burlington City Hall, constructed in 1928 in 1980, at the suggestion of his close friend and political confidant Richard Sugarman, a professor of religion at the University of Vermont, Sanders ran for mayor of Burlington, Vermont. Population 38,000. The 39-year-old Sanders ran against incumbent Democratic Mayor Gordon Gordy Paquette, a five-term mayor who had served as a member of the Burlington City Council for 13 years before that, building extensive community ties and a willingness to cooperate with Republican leaders in controlling appointments to various commissions. Republicans had found Paquette so unobjectionable that they failed to field a candidate in the March 1981 race against him, leaving Sanders as his principal opponent. Sanders' effort was further aided by the decision of the candidate of the Citizens Party, Greg Gumma, to exit the race so as not to split the progressive vote. Two other candidates in the race, independents Richard Bove and Joe McGrath, proved to be essentially non-factors in the campaign, with the battle coming down to Paquette and Sanders. Sanders castigated the pro-development incumbent as an ally of prominent shopping center developer Antonio Pomerleau, while Paquette warned of ruin for Burlington if Sanders was elected. The Sanders campaign was bolstered by a wave of optimistic volunteers as well as by a series of endorsements from university professors, social welfare agencies, and the police. Union. The final result came as a shock to the local political establishment, with the maverick Sanders winning by just 10 votes. Sanders was re-elected three times, defeating both Democratic and Republican candidates. He received 53% of the vote in 1983 and 55% in 1985. In his final run for mayor in 1987, Sanders defeated Paul Lafayette, a Democrat endorsed by both major parties during his mayoralty. Sanders called himself a socialist and was so described in the press during his first term. His supporters, including the First Citizens Party city councillor Terry Borishus, formed the Progressive Coalition, the forerunner of the Vermont Progressive Party. The Progressives never held more than six seats on the 13-member city council, but they had enough to keep the council from overriding Sanders's vetoes. Under Sanders, Burlington became the first city in the country to fund community trust housing during the 1980s. Sanders was a staunch critic of U.S. foreign policy in Latin America. In 1985, Burlington City Hall hosted a foreign policy speech by Noam Chomsky. In his introduction, Sanders praised Chomsky as a very vocal and important voice in the wilderness of intellectual life in America and said he was delighted to welcome a person who I think we're all very proud of. Sanders' administration balanced the city budget and drew a minor league baseball team, the Vermont Reds, then the AA affiliate of the Cincinnati Reds, to Burlington. Under his leadership, Burlington sued the local television cable franchise, winning reduced rates for customers. As mayor, Sanders led extensive downtown revitalization projects. One of his signature achievements was the improvement of Burlington's Lake Champlain waterfront in 1981. Sanders campaigned against the unpopular plans by Burlington developer Tony Pomerleau to convert the then industrial waterfront property owned by the Central Vermont Railway into expensive condominiums, hotels, and offices. Sanders ran under the slogan "Burlington is not for sale" and successfully supported a plan that redeveloped the waterfront area into a mixed-use district featuring housing, parks, and public space. Today, the waterfront area includes many parks and miles of public beach and bike paths, a boathouse, and a science center. Sanders hosted and produced a public access television program, Bernie Speaks with the Community. From 1986 to 1988, he collaborated with 30 Vermont musicians to record a folk album, We Shall Overcome, in 1987. In 1986, Sanders unsuccessfully challenged incumbent Governor Madeleine Cunin Dee in her run for re-election. Running as an independent, Sanders finished in third place with 144% of the vote. Cunin won with 47%, followed by Lieutenant Governor Peter P. Smith R. with 38% in 1987, U.S. News. 2013, Burlington was regarded as one of the most livable cities in the nation after serving 4 two-year terms. Sanders chose not to seek re-election in 1989. He lectured in political science at Harvard University's Kennedy School of Government that year and at Hamilton College in 1991. U.S. House of Representatives. See also, Electoral History of Bernie Sanders. Sanders' 1990 victory was heralded by the Washington Post and others as the first socialist elected to the United States House of Representatives in decades. Sanders served in the House from 1991 until he became a senator in 2007 elections. In 1988, incumbent Republican Congressman Jim Jeffords decided to run for the U.S. Senate, vacating the House seat representing Vermont's at-large congressional district. Former Lieutenant Governor Peter P. Smith R. won the House election with a plurality, securing 41% of the vote. Sanders, who ran as an independent, placed second with 38% of the vote, while Democratic State Representative Paul N. Poirier placed third with 19% of the vote. 2 years later, Sanders ran for the seat again and defeated the incumbent Smith by a margin of 56% to 39%. Sanders was the first independent elected to the U.S. House of Representatives since Fraser Reams' election to represent Ohio 40 years earlier. He served as a representative for 16 years, winning re-election by large margins except during the 1994 Republican Revolution, when he won by 33%, with 498% of the vote. Tenure. Sanders in 1991. During his first year in the House, Sanders often alienated allies and colleagues with his criticism of both political parties as working primarily on behalf of the wealthy in 1991, Sanders co-founded the Congressional Progressive Caucus, a group of mostly liberal Democrats that Sanders chaired for its first 8 years. While still refusing to join the Democratic Party or caucus in 1993, Sanders voted against the Brady Bill, which mandated federal background checks and imposed a waiting period on firearm purchasers in the United States. The bill passed by a vote of 238-187 in 1994. Sanders voted in favor of the Violent Crime Control and Law Enforcement Act. Sanders said he voted for the bill because it included the Violence Against Women Act and the ban on certain assault weapons. He was nevertheless extremely critical of the other parts of the bill, though he acknowledged that, clearly, there are some people in our society who are horribly violent, who are deeply sick and sociopathic, and clearly these people must be put behind bars in order to protect society from them. He maintained in his intervention before the House that the government's ill-thought policies played a large part in dooming tens of millions of young people to a future of bitterness, misery, hopelessness, drugs, crime, and violence. In this same intervention, he argued that the repressive policies introduced by the bill were not addressing the causes of violence, stating that we can create meaningful jobs, rebuilding our society, or we can build more jails. In 2005, he voted for the Protection of Lawful Commerce in Arms Act. The act's purpose was to prevent firearms manufacturers and dealers from being held liable for negligence when crimes have been committed with their products in 2015. Sanders defended his vote, saying, "If somebody has a gun and it falls into the hands of a murderer and the murderer kills somebody with a gun, do you hold the gun manufacturer responsible not any more than you would hold a hammer company responsible if somebody beats somebody over the head with a hammer?" Sanders voted against the resolutions authorizing the use of force against Iraq in 1991 and 2002, and opposed the 2003 invasion of Iraq. He voted for the 2001 authorization for use of military force against terrorists that has been cited as the legal justification for controversial military actions since the September 11 attacks. Sanders voted for a non-binding resolution expressing support for troops at the outset of the invasion of Iraq, but gave a floor speech criticizing the partisan nature of the vote and the George W. Bush administration's actions in the run-up to the war regarding the investigation of what turned out to be a leak of CIA agent Valerie Plame's identity by a State Department official. Sanders stated, "The revelation that the president authorized the release of classified information in order to discredit an Iraq war critic should tell every member of Congress that the time is now for a serious investigation of how we got into the war in Iraq and why Congress can no longer act as a rubber stamp for the president." Sanders was a consistent critic of the Patriot Act as a member of Congress. He voted against the original Patriot Act legislation after its 357-66 passage in the House. Sanders sponsored and voted for several subsequent amendments and acts attempting to curtail its effects, and voted against each reauthorization in June 2005. Sanders proposed an amendment to limit Patriot Act provisions that allow the government to obtain individuals' library and book buying records. The amendment passed the House by a bipartisan majority, but was removed on November 4 of that year in House-Senate negotiations and never became law. Sanders meeting with students at Milton High School in Milton, Vermont, 2004. In March 2006, after a series of resolutions passed in various Vermont towns calling for him to bring articles of impeachment against George W. Bush, Sanders stated that it would be impractical to talk about impeachment with Republicans in control of the House and Senate still. Sanders made no secret of his opposition to the Bush administration, which he regularly criticized for its cuts to social programs. Sanders was a vocal critic of Federal Reserve Chair Alan Greenspan. In June 2003, during a question and answer discussion with the then chairman, Sanders told Greenspan that he was concerned that Greenspan was way out of touch and that you see your major function in your position as the need to represent the wealthy and large corporations. In October 2008, after Sanders had been elected to the Senate, Greenspan admitted to Congress that his economic ideology regarding risky mortgage loans was flawed in 1998. Sanders voted and advocated against rolling back the Glass-Steagall legislation provisions that kept investment banks and commercial banks separate entities on November 2, 2005. Sanders voted against the Online Freedom of Speech Act, which would have exempted the Internet from the campaign finance restrictions of the McCain-Feingold bill. U.S. Senate election's main articles, United States Senate election in Vermont, 2006, and United States Senate election in Vermont, 2012. Sanders being sworn in as a U.S. Senator by then Vice President Dick Cheney in the old Senate chamber. January 2007. Sanders entered the race for the U.S. Senate on April 21, 2005, after Senator Jim Jeffords announced that he would not seek a fourth term. Chuck Schumer, chairman of the Democratic Senatorial Campaign Committee, endorsed Sanders, a critical move as it meant that no Democrat running against Sanders could expect to receive financial help from the party. Sanders was also endorsed by Senate Minority Leader Harry Reid of Nevada and Democratic National Committee Chairman and former Vermont Governor Howard Dean. Dean said in May 2005 that he considered Sanders an ally who votes with the Democrats 98% of the time. Then Senator Barack Obama also campaigned for Sanders in Vermont in March 2006. Sanders entered into an agreement with the Democratic Party, much as he had as a congressman, to be listed in their primary but to decline the nomination should he win, which he did in the most expensive political campaign in Vermont's history. Sanders defeated businessman Rich Tarrant by an approximately 2-to-1 margin. Many national media outlets projected Sanders as the winner just after the polls closed. Before any returns came in, he was re-elected in 2012 with 71% of the vote. Sanders was only the third senator from Vermont to caucus with the Democrats, after Jeffords and Leahy. His caucusing with the Democrats gave them a 51-49 majority in the Senate during the 110th Congress in 2007-08. The Democrats needed 51 seats to control the Senate because Vice President Dick Cheney would have broken any tie in favor of the Republicans when he officially announced his intention to seek the Democratic nomination for president. Sanders set himself on a path to become only the second Democrat to represent Vermont in the Senate, the other being Leahy. Tenure polling conducted in August 2011 by Public Policy Polling found that Sanders's approval rating was 67% and his disapproval rating 28%, making him then the third most popular senator in the country. Both the NAACP and the NHLA have given Sanders 100% voting scores during his tenure in the Senate. In 2015, Sanders was named one of the top five of the Forward 50 in a November 2015 Morning Consult poll. Sanders had an approval rating of 83% among his constituents, making him the most popular senator in the country as an independent. Sanders worked out a deal with the Senate Democratic leadership in which he agreed to vote with the Democrats on all procedural matters, except with permission from Democratic Whip Dick Durbin, a request that is rarely made or granted in return. He was allowed to keep his seniority and received the committee seats that would have been available to him as a Democrat. In 2013-14, he was chairman of the United States Senate Committee on Veterans Affairs during the Veterans Health Administration scandal. Sanders was free to vote as he pleased on policy matters, but almost always voted with the Democrats' budget play. Media. Sanders spoke for over 8 hours in his December 2010 filibuster. On September 24, 2008, Sanders posted an open letter to Treasury Secretary Henry Paulson decrying the initial bank bailout proposal. It drew more than 8,000 citizen cosigners in 24 hours on January 26, 2009. Sanders and Democrats Robert Byrd, Russ Feingold, and Tom Harkin were the sole majority members to vote against confirming Timothy Geithner as United States Secretary of the Treasury on December 10, 2010, Sanders delivered an 8-filibuster on corporate greed and the decline of our middle class, with authorial proceeds going to Vermont non-profit charitable organizations. Senate Budget Committee. In January 2015, Sanders became the ranking minority member of the Senate Budget Committee. He appointed economics professor Stephanie Kelton, a modern monetary theory scholar and self-described deficit owl, as the chief economic advisor for the committee's Democratic minority and presented a report aimed at helping rebuild the disappearing middle class, which included proposals to raise the minimum wage, boost infrastructure spending, and increase Social Security payments. Committee. Assignments. Committee on the Budget. Ranking Member. Committee on Environment and Public Works. Subcommittee on Clean Air and Nuclear Safety. Subcommittee on Green Jobs and the New Economy. Subcommittee on Transportation and Infrastructure. Committee on Energy and Natural Resources. Subcommittee on Energy. Subcommittee on National Parks. Subcommittee on Water and Power. Committee on Health, Education, Labor, and Pensions. Subcommittee on Children and Families. Subcommittee on Primary Health and Aging. Ranking Member. Committee on Veterans Affairs. Former Chair. 2016 Presidential Campaign. Main Articles: Bernie Sanders Presidential Campaign, 2016 and Democratic Party Presidential Primaries, 2016 Sanders before a crowd in Conway, New Hampshire, August 2015 Sanders announced his intention to seek the Democratic Party's nomination for president on April 30, 2015, in an address on the Capitol lawn. His campaign was officially launched on May 26, 2015, in Burlington. In his announcement, Sanders said, "I don't believe that the men and women who defended American democracy fought to create a situation where billionaires own the political process," and made this a central idea throughout his campaign. Senator Elizabeth Warren welcomed Sanders's entry into the race, saying, "I'm glad to see him get out there and give his version of what leadership in this country should be." On June 19, 2015, the Ready for Warren organization, which had unsuccessfully tried to draft Warren to run for president, endorsed Sanders and rebranded itself Ready to Fight. Unlike the other major candidates, Sanders stated that he would not pursue funding through a super PAC, instead focusing on small individual donations. His presidential campaign raised $15 million within 24 hours of his official announcement. At year's end, the campaign had raised a total of $73 million from more than 1 million people, making 25 million donations, with an average donation of $2,716. The campaign reached 325 million donations by the end of January 2016, raising $20 million in that month alone. Sanders supporters lined up to hear him speak in Seattle, Washington. March 2016, Sanders used social media to help his campaign gain momentum, posting content to online platforms such as Twitter and Facebook and answering questions on Reddit. He gained a large grassroots organizational following online. A July 29, 2015, meetup organized online brought 100,000 supporters to more than 3,500 simultaneous events nationwide. Sanders' campaign events in June 2015 drew overflow crowds around the country. To his surprise, when Hillary Clinton and Sanders made public appearances within days of each other in Des Moines, Iowa, Sanders drew larger crowds, even though he had already made numerous stops around the state, and Clinton's visit was her first in 2015 on July 1, 2015. Sanders's campaign stop in Madison, Wisconsin, drew the largest crowd of any 2016 presidential candidate to that date, with an estimated turnout of 10,000 over the following weeks. He gained even larger crowds, 11,000 in Arizona, 15,000 in Seattle, and 28,000 in Portland. ANBC, Wall Street Journal poll conducted in May found Clinton and presumptive Republican nominee Donald Trump in a dead heat, but the same poll found that if Sanders were the Democratic nominee, 53% of voters would support him to 39% for Trump. Clinton and Trump were the least popular likely candidates in the poll's history, while Sanders received a 43% positive, 36% negative rating. Polls showed that Democratic voters older than 50 preferred Clinton by a large margin, but those under 50 overwhelmingly favored Sanders. Sanders speaking at a rally in East Los Angeles, California, in May 2016 after the last primary election, the District of Columbia's. On June 14, Clinton became the presumptive Democratic nominee. Sanders met with her on June 16 and issued a press release reading, "Senator Sanders and Secretary Clinton met in Washington on Tuesday evening and had a positive discussion about how best to bring more people into the political process and about the dangerous threat that Donald Trump poses to our nation." Sanders congratulated Secretary Clinton on the campaign she has run and said he appreciated her strong commitment to stopping Trump in the general election. That evening, Sanders gave a live online speech to his supporters, saying, "The political revolution continues." On July 12, Sanders formally endorsed Clinton at a rally in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, but he continued to work with the Democratic National Convention organizers to implement the progressive positions he had been campaigning for. Speaking at the Democratic National Convention on July 25, Sanders gave Clinton his full support, saying, "Any objective observer will conclude that, based on her ideas and her leadership, Hillary Clinton must become the next president of the United States." On October 28, 2016, Sanders was declared an eligible write-in candidate for president in California, with Tulsi Gabbard as the vice presidential running mate. Democratic Party Presidential Debates main article, Democratic Party Presidential Debates 2016. See also, 2016 Democratic National Committee email leak. Bernie Sanders speaking at the Democratic National Convention in Philadelphia, on July 25, 2016. The 2016 Democratic Party Presidential Debates occur among candidates in the campaign for the Democratic Party's nomination for the President of the United States in the 2016 presidential election, the DNC announced in May 2015 that there would be 6 debates, which was later increased to 10. 2 debates took place on a Saturday, 2 on Sunday, 3 on a Thursday, 1 on a Tuesday and 1 on a Wednesday. Critics, including the Sanders campaign, alleged that the debate schedule was part of the DNC's deliberate attempt to protect the front-runner, Hillary Clinton. Clinton expressed willingness to hold more debates. On February 3, 2016, just ahead of the second New Hampshire debate, Clinton's and Sanders' campaigns agreed in principle to holding 4 more debates, also sanctioned by the DNC, for a total of 10. Clinton dropped out of the 10th debate, scheduled to take place just prior to the California elections, citing a need to devote her time making direct contact with voters in California. Sanders expressed disappointment that Clinton would cancel the debate before the largest and most important primary in the presidential nominating process. Party affiliation. Since 2015, Sanders campaigning for Hillary Clinton at Nashua Community College. In October 2016. In November 2015, Sanders announced that he would be a Democrat from then on, and will run in any future elections as a Democrat. On February 4, 2016, Sanders said, "Of course I am a Democrat and running for the Democratic nomination." In 2016, many additional sources, such as PBS, The Wall Street Journal, and CBS News, described Sanders as a Democrat. The United States Senate website includes pages that refer to Sanders as an independent as well as pages that refer to him as a Democrat. In 2016, his official Senate press releases still referred to him as an independent, or omitted party affiliation following his presidential campaign. Sanders returned to the Senate as an independent Our Revolution organization. In August 2016, Sanders founded Our Revolution, an organization dedicated to educating voters about political issues, getting people involved in the political process, and recruiting and supporting candidates for local, state, and national office. Election days come and go, but the struggle for economic, social, racial, and environmental justice must continue. We have the guts and the energy to take on the special interests, win critical battles on the most important issues of our time, and redefine what's possible in this country. Now it's time for all of us to get to work. He also announced plans to establish a Sanders Institute to address issues that he said the corporate media has failed to focus on, including the disappearing middle class, massive income inequality, horrific levels of poverty, and problems affecting seniors and children. Sanders' book Our Revolution was released in November 2016 in a related effort. Former Sanders presidential campaign staffers formed a political organization, Brand New Congress, to elect congressional representatives in line with the campaign's political platform. Political positions, part of a series on socialism in The United States History. Utopian Socialism. New Harmony. Brook Farm. Oneida Community. Icarians. Bishop Hill. Commune. Progressive Era. St. Louis Commune. 1912 Lawrence. Textile Strike. Labor Unionization. Women's Suffrage. Haymarket Affair. May Day. Green Corn Rebellion. Repression and Persecution. Espionage Act of 1917. First Red Scare. American Defense Society. American Protective League. Seattle General Strike. Communist Party USA and African Americans. Communism in the Labor Movement 1919-37. Communism in the Labor Movement 1937-50. McCarthyism. Smith Act. Black Riders Liberation Party. Committees of Correspondence for Democracy and Socialism. CDCS. Communist Party USA. Democratic Socialists of America. Freedom Road. Socialist Organization. Freedom Socialist Party. Industrial Workers of the World. International Socialist Organization. New African Black Panther Party. New Students for a Democratic Society. Party for Socialism and Liberation. Peace and Freedom Party. Progressive Labor Party. Revolutionary Communist Party. Socialist Action. Socialist Alternative. Socialist Equality Party. Socialist Organizer. Socialist Party. Socialist Workers Party. Spartacist League. Workers World Party. World Socialist Party of the United States. Defunct parties and organizations. American Labor Party. American Workers Party. Black Panther Party. Communist League of America. Communist Workers Party. Democratic Socialist Federation. Democratic Socialist Organizing Committee. Farmer Labor Party. Maoist Internationalist Movement. New American Movement. Proletarian Party of America. Puerto Rican Socialist Party. Social Democracy of America. Social Democratic Federation. Social Democratic Party of America. Social Democrats, USA. Socialist Labor Party of America. Socialist Party of America. Students for a Democratic Society. Weather Underground. White Panther Party. Workers Party of the United States. Youth International Party. Literature. The Jungle. Appeal to Reason. International Socialist Review. Looking Backward. The Other America. Daily Worker.